Hi, this is Sharon from Printable Henry, and today I'm going to show you how to make a custom portrait using clipart from this kit. This is a BFF Best Friends custom clipart, and it's available here at PrintableHenry.com. It's the BFF Best Friends custom clipart. So the image that I'm going to show is these three girls, the three sisters. Once it's done, you can use this for, you may have seen it on sublimation for mugs or custom prints like this. When you download this kit, it comes in a zip file. When you unzip it, you'll see that it comes with this basic commercial license, and that allows you to use this clipart, license it for up to 500 uses. And it also comes with a Photoshop document. If you want to work in Photoshop, you can use this one. Then it comes with the same images that are in the Photoshop document are PNG images. These are 300 DPI. These are all the PNG images that are included. You'll see lots of hairstyles, denim jacket, arms, bodies. These are in brown tones and pale skin tones, and some different clothing, tops and bottoms. And I'll put this up in the corner just for a reference to remind me what pieces I'm getting. So the first thing I'll do is start on this girl that's on the right. And I know that I'm going to use the hair. And I'm working in Photoshop. So if you're working on any other programs, you can use things like Design Space or Procreate, anything that lets you take an image, a PNG image, and drop it in and arrange it. So there's tons of, I'll put a list in of the most popular programs, but you can use anything. People have used Word, they've used PowerPoint, but there's some that are the most popular. So anyway, what I'm going to start doing is just copying and pasting these images that I know I'm going to be using. So I'll have her hair, I'll put her t-shirt in, and the bottoms, and then she has the two straight arms, put those in, oops, not that one, this one. Okay, now that I have these images in my document, all I have to do is arrange them. So I'll take the t-shirt and move that over. Now the t-shirt, I'm putting this on top of the jeans. So this, if you have a program that has you put images in front of or behind, the t-shirt is in front of the jeans. And I'll move her hair here. It's kind of... I think I'll turn that off so you can see. And then I'll just move her arms in place. And this one is here. And now the arm, you can see the arm is behind the t-shirt and behind the jeans. So I'll put that here. And we've got another arm, we'll put that here. Now a trick that I use just to kind of see if I have them in the right place on her t-shirt, I'm just gonna change that opacity so I can kind of see where that is. And I think that's close enough, but you know what, I might move, I use my arrow buttons on my keyboard sometimes just to move it just a tiny bit. So I think I'll move it just a little bit over. Okay, and then I'll make the t-shirt back to normal. And we have our first girl. So if we look at our sample, we've got, let me move the sample. We know our middle girl. And for her, I'm gonna get her hairstyle. And we've got her body. And then she has the black crop top. And some black jeans. So I'll copy and paste those in. Okay, and I'm going to turn off that sample again. So for this one, I will just move the jeans on top. Oh, you know what? I guess I better move her in her spot first. And I know what I want to tell you on this one, because what the position of this middle girl is actually going to be determined. Let me get her arms in there. It depends, since I want this arm to be on her shoulder here, that is going to determine where I position this middle girl. And I can see right now that this arm's going to need to be rotated a little bit. So let me move her body a little bit closer just to give me a better idea. And then I'll just use my rotation tool to rotate this a bit. So that's a little closer, a little bit more maybe. Now I'll also turn off her hair so we can see better. Okay. So that's pretty close. And now I can move her body a little closer to this arm. And I think I'll adjust this arm just a tiny bit more. Okay, that looks pretty good. And now I can put her jeans where they go. And these, you can see these jeans are in front of the body. And I'll move her top. Again, this is on top of the body. And I'll add her, the left arm, position that. Let's see if we've got it. And I'll wait to rotate this to see where that denim jacket fits in. Now this arm is in front of the body, but behind the black top. Okay, move that, just maybe adjust it just a bit. And again, I'm using the arrow tools on my keyboard because I think that moves it just the tiniest bit. Okay, so let me go ahead and put her hair back since we're done with her. I'll go ahead and move her braids, get those here. And again, you can see that's on top of the body. Okay, now we'll move on to the denim jacket. Now this is a three pieces. It has these two sleeves and then the back. So I'll move the back where I want it. And again, she's has her hand on her shoulder. And then I'll move this sleeve in place. Here. And if you want, sometimes I'll just see, okay, it's mostly covered by her arm, but if you want to see exactly where it is, and then the straight arm here. Okay, and we have her, that's here. Now we also need another body because, the girl on the right with the white t-shirt, none of her body is showing because her hair is covering it. But since her neck is showing here, I'm going to need another body. So I'm in Photoshop, so I'm just duplicating it. But you can also just copy and paste it again from your master files. And I'll put that. And I can kind of see I want the neck centered in that collar. And now, again, I'm just adjusting it. You're not going to see any of this body because it's going to be moved behind the jacket, like that. And now I can see better where to adjust her hair. And again, I'm going to copy another pair of the black jeans. I'm just duplicating mine, but you can copy and paste it, like I said, from your master file. And move that up. Now these jeans are going to go below the jacket, but in front of the body, like that. And then we just have one more piece, and that's her hand on the end, and that just kind of peeks out of that sleeve, like that. Okay, I think that's it. I may want to move this girl a little bit closer. Let me see if I can do that. Okay, I'm going to grab the t-shirt, the jeans, and both arms and move it over just a hair. Because now, if I move her hair over, then I see a little bit more of the hand, girl in the middle, see her hand a little bit more. Okay, so I'm happy with that. Now, at this point, I would probably add some names down here. And it's ready to print. So there you go. Now it's ready to print. And like I say, you can use these for mugs or for custom prints. And it is at PrintableHenry.com, BFF Best Friends Custom Clip Art. So let me know if you have any questions, if there's any other portraits or designs or tips or tricks that you'd like to see, and I'll be sure and show them to you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.